Hi everyone. You caught us just in time. We're about ready to go get dinner.
Let's go.
Well, you probably thought we were going out to dinner. We're going out to our garden grocery store here in the backyard. I mean, this is why we do it. We grow our own food, we come outside and pick it, and we take it inside to eat it. There's nothing like a summer organic harvest. These strawberries are looking absolutely tasty. Look at the color on these things. The strawberry crate towers have been such an amazing project over the past couple of years, and it's so much fun to come out here and pick berries. One of my favorite ways to eat them is just fresh and tasty on top of yogurt. Oh, such a good breakfast or lunch. Camera guy loves to take these to work with him, don't you, camera guy?
Yep.
So tasty. Nothing like organic berries. I think there's a lot more up here. Couple in here that are red, nice and shiny. Oh, would you look at that. Okay, let's check out the next strawberry tower here. We're kind of getting to the end of strawberry season, but these towers have been super productive for me. I've been harvesting little baskets of berries all summer long. Oh, these are so tasty. They like to hide down in here. And the weather is getting perfect now for strawberries. It's been about 80, 85 during the days. The past few weeks, things have really started to cool off, and the garden is loving it. Now, I know I've got some tomatoes back in here to harvest too. There's nothing like a tasty, fresh, homegrown tomato, right? This variety here is called Siberian tomato. And it's supposed to be more cold tolerant, so I'm hoping that these grow throughout the winter time here in California. Look at the red on that. Wow, tasty. I think maybe BLTs for tonight too. Now this one here is not quite ready, so we're gonna leave that, or it's still green. Now this tomato here is a beautiful lucid gem tomato. It's a gorgeous tomato. Look at right here. Aren't those beautiful? You can see how it's getting a little bit of a purple sheen to the top here. Now underneath here, I've covered them because the rats love to come and take a munch out of them. And unfortunately, I saw when we walked by, I don't think my strategy worked here. I think the rats found my tomatoes. Oh my gosh.
They managed to get in anyway.
Oh, it just kills me. Look at that. Look at the gorgeous color on that tomato. And they know just when it gets ripe, this one's gonna have to go to the compost pile.
Bummer.
Oh, what a bummer. Well, the good thing is I've got some more tomatoes coming on, so probably in another couple of days, I'll have some other ones ripe. Oh my gosh, they're just having a feast.
Yep.
Oops, cut that one off too. Well, I'll take that one into the house to ripen it. Oh, look, there's another ripe one though.
This one's a beaut.
I didn't even see that one. Oh my gosh, look at the color. What a beautiful tomato.
Untouched.
I'm super excited about my butternut squash here. I don't have any ready to harvest today, but I love trellising butternut squash. I think it looks so pretty. And maybe another month or so they'll be ready. You can tell they're ready when the stem turns to like a dark brown color there. So we'll make sure we do a harvest when those are ready. Now it's time for blackberries. I have a ton of blackberries ready to harvest. Super excited. Probably one of my favorite things I've been harvesting this summer. This year, I've had more blackberries than ever. Actually pruned my blackberries back last winter, and I gave them like worm castings and worm tea. Oh my gosh, you guys have got to see these. They are absolutely amazing. So tasty. Oh my gosh, look at the size of those berries. Beautiful.
Wow.
And these we definitely just love to eat fresh. Sometimes they don't even make it into the house. But I have a nice little haul tonight. Look at these berries. They're huge.
So many.
Oh my gosh. This is so exciting. They're so tasty.
So crazy to get this out of your backyard and not be buying this at a store.
I know.
So cool.
I gotta get these for the birds, get them too.
It is a little bit of a game, huh?
It is. Get them just when they're ripe, but if you leave them on too long, the critters come.
Yeah, the rats got to us on the tomato.
Yeah,
But you did get that one beauty.
Yeah. Oops, that one's a little bit overripe. The birds are not gonna get these. Oh, this is just incredible. Look at these berries. Maybe over some French vanilla ice cream. These bushes are loaded down. This is a Mr. Stripey tomato. Love all the names. Looking delicious. And right next to it is a gorgeous black beauty. Look at the color on these. These are not quite ready, but oh my gosh, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? So maybe another week or so, those will be ready. And right here is a little Napoli tomato. It's a nice little compact container variety. Really a pretty little tomato. And this is my first harvest off of these, so this is super exciting. I love the size of these too. Come on, we're gonna head over to the yellow Brandywine tomato. Now remember, we just harvested two huge tomatoes on this plant on the Beefsteak Tomato Challenge video, a 1.4 pounder and a 1.6 pounder. And I think I've got a couple more that are ready over here on the other side. Now I'm hoping for the best on these plants. You can see I covered these up to protect them from the rats as well. And I haven't looked at them for several days. So let's check them out. Ooh, look at that. Now that's a nice tomato. No rat damage. Wow.
That's beautiful.
This is beautiful. I'm gonna guess it's about maybe 1 pound and a couple of ounces. Gorgeous. All right, let's check out, see if this one is ripe underneath here. It's not quite all the way ripe. See that green on the top? But I'm gonna go ahead and harvest it because I definitely don't want the rats to get this. These yellow Brandywines are such a nice size. Wow. Okay, now we're gonna check out the peppers. I'm sure I have some that are ready to harvest. This is a nice looking harvest basket, don't you think? So I've got a couple really pretty yellow sweet banana peppers right here. And they're a little bit on the small side, but I'm gonna go ahead and harvest them. And the weather is cooling down and it's really gonna help everything in the garden take off. These are so nice. I love these sweet banana peppers. They're good on just about anything. We love eating them on garden fresh pizza. But I know right behind here, I've got one of my favorites, California Wonder Peppers, and these are all in my pepper seed collection. What a beautiful pepper. Look at that color. It's a beautiful sweet pepper. These are so tasty on the grill.
Yeah, it's looking so good through the camera,
Evid. Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh.
Look at the color. So we might have to have some blackberries and then grill up some peppers for dinner. Now peppers you can harvest at any stage. This one back here is a little bit smaller and you can see it's not quite red yet. So believe it or not, it's gonna turn red like this. But you can always just harvest it when it's, you know, a different color and then see, you know, what stage you like to harvest it at. Now here's some other beautiful peppers. Unfortunately, I don't have the tag here. I thought they were California Wonders, but California Wonders are usually the typical bell pepper shape. So this looks like a longer shaped pepper. Pretty sure it's a sweet pepper, but aren't those colors just absolutely amazing? Growing your own food is just so much fun. I got some more peppers over here. California Wonder. So prolific. Look at these beauties. And this plant has actually been in for, I think, a couple of years now. And you can see it's kind of taken a beating. I've had some bugs going on here. So I'm going to trim all this stuff back later on and this plant should bounce right back. But I love these California Wonders. Oh. Showed you guys this plant on the Beefsteak Tomato Challenge video. Absolutely gotten taken over by spider mites, unfortunately. Treating it with some neem oil, spraying it down with water, and I've got some tomatoes to harvest. So they're not the most beautiful looking tomatoes, but they're still edible. These tomatoes are looking great. Right next to it is an Arkansas Traveler tomato. It's a heat tolerant tomato. And these have done really well, not even covered with shade cloth during the triple digit temperatures. So they're living up to their name. Well, it's been so much fun to grow the flowers along with the vegetables this year. All these flowers are in my pollinator seed collection. Aren't they beautiful? The cosmos, the zinnias, absolutely gorgeous. I love the color out here, and here the bees buzzing around is so much fun. So here we have a Tommy Toe tomato, and these are just starting to get ripe. I actually planted this tomato plant very late in the season, maybe 6 weeks or so ago. So the tomatoes are just starting to come on. A nice little small sized tomato. And from what I've heard, these plants are super, super productive. It's my first year growing it, so I'm really excited to try these. But lots of green tomatoes on here. And also the plant is just loaded down with flowers. So I think this is gonna be a really productive plant through the winter time as well. Now, right over here is some straight-necked yellow squash. Such a delicious variety. And these we actually are in my late summer garden seed collection. What an amazing, tender squash. It's so pretty. I love the color. Isn't that beautiful? And it's gonna be a lot of fun to mix these and grill these up with the peppers that we just harvested. Makes for such a pretty presentation. Oh, I think we got one more here.
God, they're easy to miss.
They are. Now these are the purple beauty pepper. You guys ready for this? Look at how gorgeous those are. Look at that color. Absolutely beautiful. The plant is loaded down with peppers. These are in my pepper seed collection, and I'm so excited about these. Oh my goodness. Look at the color on these. You can see there's a little bit of green tinge there on the front.
There you go.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Gosh, those are.
I can see why they're called purple beauty. So pretty.
Like kinda, eight of them.
Oh, there's so many of them. Kind of interesting how this one's growing upside down. See that?
Hmm.
Let me pull that one off. And that one's so much bigger than the other ones too. Don't even quite know where to cut it. Oh, there we go. There's the stem. Oh my goodness, that is so pretty. I'm gonna go ahead and harvest all of these. You can see I've got some bug holes in here too, so I need to get out here and spray with some neem oil. One more good size one down here.
Another one behind
it. Oh wow, beautiful.
Wait, let me see that one, I missed it. Wow.
Another little one behind it. I'm gonna leave the rest of them on here to size up a little bit. And this tomato plant, first time growing green zebra tomatoes. You can see I got my protection in place here. And you can see all the spider mite damage on this too. So I'm really disappointed about the spider mites, but better luck next year, right? And let's see what we got under here. See if my wrap protection worked. This one was just getting ripe a couple of days ago, so I covered it up, and oh wow. Now green tomatoes, that are supposed to be green anyway, are a little hard to tell when they're ripe, but this one looks absolutely beautiful. Nice little color on there, and you can tell they're ripe when they just kind of give a little bit like that. Oh my gosh, that's beautiful. Called Green Zebra.
They show us that one.
Yeah. Little striping on it. Oh, that is so pretty. That is so, so pretty. There's another green zebra back in here. This one is not quite ripe. See how it's like a lot firmer? So it doesn't give quite as much as the other one does. And the other one, you can see it had some little orange. A little orange color. This one is still totally green, so I'm gonna wait a couple days on that one. I have to say though, the zinnias back in here are absolutely stunning. Look at this zinnia.
Yeah,
Is that gorgeous? This is one of the cut and come again zinnias from the, I think it's in the pollinator collection. The color on this is absolutely amazing. Okay, nice Roma tomatoes. Roma tomatoes are so good for sauces, for salsas. They're nice and meaty. They don't have a lot of juice to them, so they make great canning tomatoes, and there's a bunch of ripe ones in here.
Here we go.
Now catching a camera guy.
That's the one.
There we go. Nice. I think I've got a couple around this side.
Yeah, there's a green one over here. I don't know if it's ready, though.
Gotta be red. These ones gotta be red.
Yeah,
that one's not quite ready, but this plant is loaded down. Looking good. We'll give those another week or so. Wow, there's quite a few Romas under here. Oops, this one got a little... Missed this one. It's overripe. That one will be for the compost pile. I think this one got pecked by birds. See those little holes there? So that'll be a good compost pile one too. To get in here and prune out this tomato plant to give a little bit more airflow, because that helps prevent disease. Okay, come on, come on. Nice. I'm on my third harvest basket here. Oh my gosh. Jerry, do you want to do this one?
You sure?
Yeah, look at that.
Okay, I'll give it a shot.
This is a mammoth zucchini.
Yeah, you're gonna have to walk me through it. But
okay.
Yeah, let's give it a go.
Zucchini is actually better picked when it's small. This one got a little large, but it's good for zucchini lasagna or zucchini bread.
Okay.
So you just wanna grab it and slowly twist it. Slowly twist it so you don't... You wanna break off that stem where it's connected to the vine.
There it goes.
There you go. You go. You got it. Nice. Oh my gosh. That's a mammoth. How fun.
Like
organic zucchini.
Fishing pictures.
There you go.
All right.
It's a badge of honor. So we'll be making some zucchini bread this week. Now, camera guy, if you walk towards me, there's another squash. See if you can find it. It's white. I'll give you a hint. There you go. Isn't that pretty? That's one of my favorites. It's a scallop squash.
Ouch. Yep.
Yeah, the zucchini
prickly,
leaves
man.
Are kind of prickly. So you can take the pruners that are right there and just clip it right at the stem. There you go. Oh, that is such a pretty squash. I love those. It looks really pretty sliced up and then grilled because of the scalloped edges make a really nice, pretty presentation. Nice job. Camera guy is back on the camera again after harvesting these beauties.
Yeah, I actually prefer it behind the camera.
You're doing a good job. Okay. We've got a few things to harvest in this garden bed, but I'm running out of baskets. We've got three baskets full. My zucchini and scallop squash wouldn't even fit. I'm gonna grab some kale for our smoothies tomorrow. Love kale. I harvest kale every single day for smoothies. So delicious. This is the Red Russian kale.
Now, are there kale haters out there?
Yes.
And some people are like, no way on kale.
There are a lot of kale haters, but they just don't eat it the right way. If you put it in a smoothie with berries, like the blackberries or strawberries, and yogurt, and bananas, it's so good. And they've never had my kale salad. You put it with a sweet dressing, massage the kale. I know that sounds weird, but it works really well. It's delicious. Okay, so here we have a cucumber to harvest. I think this is either a Market Moor or a Boston pickling. Look at the size of that beauty. Absolutely beautiful.
It's incredible.
And my cucumbers have been really sweet this year. Sometimes cucumbers get bitter in the heat, but these have been absolutely delicious. And sometimes it's just bitter on the ends. So cut the ends off, try the middle, and make sure to get nice sweet cucumbers. You have plenty of water and fertilizer. Cucumbers kind of stalled out in the midsummer heat, but I've got some baby ones coming on right here. Now the weather's cooling down, so we're gonna have a great fall harvest of cucumbers. And I've been succession planting them, got new ones going, so I expect to be harvesting cucumbers till the weather gets cold, so that'll be a lot of fun. Now here we've got a beautiful purple pepper again. So I'm gonna clip off a couple of these that are ready. These ones are kind of on the small side. Not too sure what happened with that. I think I need to come in through here with some warm tea and give them a nice little good boost. Got some other ones back there that are not ripe, so we'll definitely leave those on. Whoops, I think I snapped that. Well, that's a good reason to go ahead and harvest it, obviously. And again, peppers you can harvest at any size, any color. These will still be great for eating. And I think we've got another straight-necked yellow squash down in here. This has been a great squash plant this year. I really like to pick them when they're much smaller than that zucchini. The younger, the more tender. Tasty. Oh, this is so yummy. We got three big, huge baskets full for our dinner tonight. Garden grocery store is the best. This is why we do it. This makes it all worthwhile. The garden gives back.
It's incredible how much we got right out of our backyard.
Absolutely amazing. We have plenty for dinner. We're gonna share some with our friends, with our family. Organic summer harvest is absolutely the best.
It was really fun to help out as well. So why don't you all share in the comments down below what you've harvested this summer?
I mean, this is why we do it. This is why we work hard to grow our own food, plant it, nurture it along, so we can have a day like this to share it with our friends and family, to take it inside and eat it for dinner. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.